So Labyrinth's a board game about terrorism and counterterrorism, the global war on terror. The original idea of Labyrinth is if we were to consider the conflict between jihadist terrorists and the West and counterterrorism as the new Cold War, what would that look like as a game? And the way that we tried to answer that question is to take Twilight Struggle, which presents a very vivid, admittedly simplified model of the Cold War struggle, and to bring that model forward into the age of terrorism. How would that work? Now, Labyrinth then turns out to be, I think, a very different game than Twilight Struggle, because the nature of the dynamics of that ideological struggle that involved a lot of politics and some violence and economics as well. The dynamics of that are different than the dynamics of Cold War. We wouldn't simply want to, you know, change the colors and have it be the same game, of course. However, the starting point was Twilight Struggle in its use of the card-driven system that is so accessible and evocative in bringing various historic actors and events into a simple core mechanic of competition, and to sort of change that around, update that, change the nature of the tools at the player's disposal to represent counterterrorism and terrorism as a global ideological struggle in those years. And so players are going to not be doing the kinds of things they do in Twilight Struggle, which is just placing influence or spurring coups, but rather they're going to be engaging in a struggle for governance of the Muslim world, in which the jihadists want it to be purist, fundamentalist, Islamist rule, and they're going to use terrorism and other means to get to that. And the U.S. leading the counterterrorism effort against al-Qaeda, which includes not only predator strikes and disrupting and arresting terrorists, but also trying underneath that terrorist threat to see to better governance in the Muslim world so that groups like al-Qaeda can't take root in the first place.